Tonight, I'm not going to pontificate tonight, so we're going to go right to it. Tonight, we want to introduce to you the Junior Athlete of the Year, Female Athlete of the Year.
The Athlete of the Year Awards are the most prestigious honors to be bestowed upon the most competitive male and female athletes for their outstanding accomplishments during the current sports year. The athlete should have placed in the top four positions at a recognized international competition, should have advanced in the final grouping stage at a major competition, or placed first in a national competition. Ladies and gentlemen, we present the nominees for the Athlete of the Year.
Anytime you're ready.
Our first nominee for the Female Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of sailing. Cecilia Wolman is the 2014 Open BIC North American Champion. In 2014, Cecilia qualified for the Youth Olympiad in Nanjing, China, where she amassed four top five finishes in the bike regatta. She further extended her sailing credentials by placing seventh in the 2014 CAC Games in Veracruz, Mexico, in laser radials. Cecilia's astounding performances have enabled her to be recognized by the Bermuda Olympic Association as a Category C Elite Athlete. Tonight, we congratulate Cecilia Wolman on her nomination. Our second nominee for the Female Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of track and field. Fahima Scraters is a prolific athlete who has represented Bermuda valiantly at the junior level. At the 2014 Caribbean Games in Martinique, she obtained two medals, gold and silver, respectively. Similarly, she copped gold in the 400 meters at the 2014 CAC Junior Championships. Fahima is no stranger to local high school competitions, and in 2014, she emerged as the KPMG Front Street Mile High School Girls Champion. She qualified for the 2014 Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, and won the B Finals. Fahima is Bermuda's current female junior record holder in the 800 and 1500 meters. Tonight, we congratulate Fahima Scraters on her nomination. Our third nominee for the Female Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of swimming. Ashley Irby is known for her amazing feats in water, both locally and internationally. She competed at the 2014 Caribbean Swimming Championships in Aruba and amassed one gold and two bronze medals. She competed at the Caribbean Island Swimming Championships in Barbados and won two silver medals. In the 11 to 12 girls age group, she has set four long course and two short course records. At the local level, she won the KPMG Middle School Girls Finals and set a new race record. Tonight, we congratulate Ashley Irby on her nomination.
The Female Athlete of the Year, Junior Athlete of the Year, Kyra Scraters.
And this is my dad chiming in, and I'd just like to thank Bermuda Pacers Bryce Stoddard.
Our first nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of triathlon. Tyler Smith qualified for the 2014 Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, and placed 19th in a very strong field. He competed in the Caribbean Junior Cycling Championships, placing second in the time trials and second in the road race. He won the Good Friday Triathlon All Ages Championships, the Bermuda Bicycling Association's Junior Criterion Championship, and the International 10K Junior Division during the International Race Weekend. Tonight, we congratulate Tyler Smith on his nomination. Our second nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of track and field. Kyle Webb is Bermuda's current male junior record holder in the 100 and 400 meters. He competed in the CAC Junior Championships in Mexico, placing third in the 100-meter finals. He won the Tampa Sun Angel Classic 200 meters in a time of 20.97 seconds, and the 400 meters at MESA NJCAA Championships in a time of 46.89, which saw him qualify for a World Junior. Tonight, we congratulate Kyle Webb on his nomination. Our third nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of swimming. Jesse Washington is a 2014 Corinthia swimming champion who amassed 2 gold medals, 1 silver medal, and 1 bronze medal. During the Caribbean Island Swimming Championships, he won 2 gold medals and 2 silver medals. He qualified for the 2014 Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, placing 34th in the 100-meter freestyle and 23rd in the 100-meter butterfly. Jesse also qualified for the Canadian Age Group Championships and placed 4th in the 100-meter butterfly. Tonight, we congratulate Jesse Washington on his nomination.
Madam Minister, below this smoke, I hope you're not be calling Masada to get tested. Madam Minister, ladies and gentlemen, our male athlete, our male junior athlete of the year, Tyler Smith.
I've had time to think a little bit more about what I wanted to say. I would also like to thank the Harbor Swimming Club as well as Winners Edge Bicycle Association, and again, the Bermuda Triathlon Association. It's been four triathletes getting awards so far this night, and I think that's a testament to how great of an organization it really is. And I'm grateful to be a part of it, and again, thank you to my parents. Thank you.
Athlete of the Year nominee, Karen Smith. Our first nominee for the Female Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of triathlon. Recapping Karen's year, she won every local event she participated in, both sprint and Olympic distances. These events included the Jackie Triathlon, the Catlin National Olympics Championship, the Aon National Sprint Championship, and the Bank of Bermuda Race. On the international scene, she placed 8th in her age group during the Ironman 70.3 World Championship in Quebec. First, at the Ironman Los Colas in Mexico in the 45 to 49 age group, and the first at the Ironman World Championship in Hawaii. Tonight, we congratulate Karen Smith on her nomination. Our final nominee for the Female Athlete of the Year award comes to us from the sport of triathlon. Recapping a great year for Flora, she participated in 16 events throughout the world. In February, she competed in the Xterra World Championships held in Cape Town, South Africa, placing first. She also had a series of first place positions in the same event at the U.S. Southeast Championship, the U.S. East Championship, and the U.S. Championship in Utah. Other notable performances by Flora were at the Scotland Commonwealth Games, where she placed 8th in the ITU and 1st during the Xterra World Championship in October, held in Hawaii. Tonight, we congratulate Flora Duffy on her nomination.
At this time, I'd like to invite. The smoke is getting to me, guys. I'm not even high yet. At this time, I'd like to invite you to the stage, representing Premier, who could not be here tonight, MP Jeff Souza, who will make the presentation on Premier's behalf. Mr. Souza, Madam Premier, guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'm getting a little confused. I am getting a little our female athlete of the year, Flora Duffy.
I've always wanted to be escorted onto a stage with a group of lovely young women bearing flags, and tonight, that's it. It's a bit presumptuous, but I did write something. So thanks very much on Flora's behalf to everybody. I suggested to Flora that probably everybody here, at least, is pretty familiar with her results. So maybe we should try and give you a glimpse of the inner Flora, and by reading out a message she sent to the Youth Olympic team, including Tyler over there. And here it is. Embrace each and every experience, for a mind that is stretched by a new experience can never go back to its old dimensions. I'm cheering for you. Bermuda is cheering for you. So go on, thrive in the moment, race fast, and enjoy the details. And hopefully the team found that inspiring. I thought it was kind of cool. Thank you. I paused for applause there, did you see that? If you've listened to any of Flora's interviews, and she does quite a lot, you know that she boosts Bermuda at every opportunity she gets. She's very proud of Bermuda and proud to be a Bermudian, and she'll be very touched and proud and grateful for the recognition that she's received tonight. So thanks once again.
Athlete of the Year nominee, Tyler Butterfield, our first nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year Award, comes to us from the sport of triathlon. During this past sports year, Tyler participated in 10 events throughout the world. In March of 2014, he participated in the Abu Dhabi International Long Pool and placed first overall. And during the Ironman Nice International Long Pool held in Nice, France, he finished in third place. While not certainly connected to triathlon events, the multiple skills he possesses earned him the winning position during the 2014 Bermuda Day Marathon, along with the Cycling Sprint Championship held in Bermuda. So we'd like to extend a heartfelt congratulations to Tyler Bottle-Peeble for his nomination. Roy Allen Birch, our next nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year Award, comes to us from the sport of swimming. Roy Allen, a two-time Olympian, represented Bermuda in the 2008 and 2012 Olympics. In August, he placed ninth in the 50-meter freestyle at the Glasgow Commonwealth Games, placed fifth in the same event in November during the CAC Games in Mexico, and finally set five short course national records and five long course national records here in Bermuda. We extend a warm congratulations to Roy Allen Birch for his nomination. Santwali Warridge, and finally, our last nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year Awards comes from the sport of Wushu Martial Arts. During the year, our recipients represented Bermuda in the international arena at the 10th Annual Pan American Wushu Championship in Costa Rica and came first in his weight class. At the 7th Annual Sanda World Cup in Jakarta, he placed second and first at the 1st Annual Pan American Sanda Cup in Mexico. With great pleasure, we congratulate Santwali Warridge for his nomination.
Competition there, and that was, I'm sure, a very challenging decision how to come to this. Anyway, it's an honor. I would like to thank the Bermuda Olympic Association, the Bermuda Triathlon Association, the Bermuda Bicycle Association. I especially would like to thank Dave Morrison and Neil Desinquois, who really got Tyler back into this sport when he was a youngster. Greg Hopkins did an amazing job helping him with cycling and his professional career there. And Patty Petty, he would never have gotten to any of the events had Patty not helped him get into the events as well as get there. So there are many, many people. And then of course, Tokyo Millennium and many of his sponsors. Thank you very much. It is an honor. I'm sorry he's not here. He too would have just loved those flags coming up with the, and by Charlie. It's fun. thank you, Bermuda. We really appreciate it.